Hello, hello, hello. Today is November 19, 2021. For me. Perhaps not for you. That depends on where you live. Problem number 124. It's a classic. And it is also within reach of people in high school, assuming that they have had some courses in physics. It's certainly not a very difficult problem. A parallel plate capacitor in vacuum is placed in a uniform magnetic field B of strength 0.1 Tesla. The direction of the magnetic field is parallel to the plates as indicated in the figure. The cross means that it is inside the paper, not coming out of the paper, but it is inside the paper. The capacitor is charged to provide a uniform electric field E of 10 to the 5 volts per meter in the direction shown. An electron enters the capacitor from the left with a speed of 3 times 10 to the 6 meters per second. That is 1% of the speed of light, by the way. Its direction of motion is at right angles to both the magnetic field and the electric field, as shown. First question. What is the net force in newtons, magnitude and direction, that the electron experiences as it enters the capacitor? Second question, which is more important. If we could change the strength of the electric and/or magnetic field, would it then be possible for the electron to pass through the capacitor in a straight line, thus undeflected? Explain your answer. As I said, it's not very difficult, maybe also not very easy. Whatever that may be, we'll be friends anyhow. That's always a given. I would like to add that last night there was a lunar eclipse. It was the longest partial lunar eclipse in, I believe, hundreds of years. But it was not total. At the East Coast here in the United States, the maximum was near 4 a.m. I woke up at 5 a.m. So it was not a maximum anymore, but half the moon was still in the Earth umbra. Very spectacular. I am not sure that it was visible in India because it may have been day there. And during the day, you can never see a lunar eclipse for obvious reasons. I enjoyed it. I got up, my wife got up, and we both saw about half the moon completely dark. I've seen many lunar eclipses in my life. They are not so uncommon. And I've seen many total lunar eclipses in my life. The interesting about the total eclipses is that the moon looks reddish. And for those of you who have some background knowledge of physics, astrophysics, they should be able to explain why the moon then looks reddish. It's not so obvious, but it is true, and it looks really very reddish. Whatever this may be, we will be friends anyhow. That's always a given.